Thank you very much. My presentation includes three parts. As time is limited, I will pass two parts quickly, and I will focus on the last part, which covers the case study. As you know, multiculturalism phenomenon has become a highly controversial topic, not only in the academic field, but also in the political agenda. The term of multicultural has been discussed broadly. Jurisdictions haven't agreed on the term. Multicultural is generally used for diversities based on different backgrounds within a society. Moreover, it's used for disadvantaged groups in a society, women, homosexuals, disabled people, etc. Australia, as a multicultural country, has given importance to sustaining harmony in the multicultural society through arrangements in law, regulations, and its institutions. Australia's main aim is to form a nation. Therefore, it has opened the doors to immigrants. As a result, it's a multicultural society whose formation based on immigrant societies. The number of ancestries that take place in ancestry classification in Census Report of Australian Bureau of Statistics shows what a multicultural society Australia is. According to ABS report, more than 270 ancestries were separately identified, and there are over 200 languages being spoken in Australia. Within these diversities, we focus on the Turkish population, which constitutes a big part of the society. After the bilateral migration agreement in 1967, between Australia and Turkey, intense Turkish migration to Australia has started. According to 2011 census report, nearly 67,000 Turkish people and two unofficial reports, around 150,000 Turkish people live in Australia. The qualifications and structures of Turkish immigrants have changed. At the beginning of intense migration, Turkish people migrated as unqualified labor. Lately, Australia has a qualified labor demand instead of unqualified labor demand. For this reason, the type of immigrants has generally changed. As a result, the features of Turkish immigrants have also changed. In recent times, Turkish people have already migrated to Australia for different reasons, such as education, family union, or qualified labor, compared to the previous migration context. In this study, I examine the opinions of Turkish people living in Australia on multiculturalist policies and the effects of settlement migration in Australia on their opinions. I analyze the results of the survey conducted to 152 Turkish immigrants living in Sydney. This study is a descriptive research adapting the snowball survey technique. The independent variable is settlement migration. I analyze the impact of settlement migration on several dependent variables to understand the perceptions of immigrants on multicultural policies applied in Australia. Australia, as an immigrant country, expected the citizens from different backgrounds adopt to Australia as their home. The expectation is that the settlement migration in host country will increase the sense of belonging to country. As you see in the table, when the settlement duration is up to 20 to 25 years, nearly half of the subjects have a sense of belonging to Turkey, and half of subjects feeling a belonging to both of Australia and Turkey. At the same settlement years, the tendency to feel belonging to Australia is very low. It has been unpredictably observed that the effect of settlement duration in a host country is not at the expected level. However, after a 25-year settlement in Australia, there are significant changes in feelings of belonging. As you see in the table, the sense of belonging to Australia has increased after 25-year settlement. It can be told that 25-year settlement is a turning point that affects sense of belonging in a host country for immigrants. To understand the thoughts of the subjects about multiculturalist policies is ask them, how do you evaluate Australia's multicultural policies? The responses to this question are complicit policy, mediocre, compulsory, idealistic, unworkable, weak or non-conclusive policy. The hypothesis is that settlement ratio has an effect on the perception of multicultural policies. When we look at the cross-set of two variables on the table, it could be seen that most of the subjects whose settlement ratio is 2 to 5 years think weak policy and compulsory policy. The subjects responding as a conclusive policy constitute a very low rate. Effects of the settlement ratio differences are obvious. With an over 25-year settlement ratio, subjects consider mostly a conclusive policy and weak policy. The overall picture shows that most of the subjects regard multicultural policies as conclusive, compulsory, and weak. The results of our study indicate that the longer settlement duration is, the more data for multicultural policies. Another question that measures the perception of multiculturalism policies is constructed like that. Do you think all cultures in Australia are treated or valued equally? The importance of this question is related with that the key feature of multiculturalism policy is built on cultural inequalities. Our hypothesis is that settlement ratio affects the perception of equality on having cultural value and treatment. Related with this question, while nearly 43% of subjects settled in Australia for 2 to 5 years responded no and absolutely no, nearly 39% responded yes and absolutely yes. Yes and no responses of the subjects having 20 to 25 years settlement ratio are equal. Moreover, with an over 25-year settlement, yes and no answers have slight changes. According to these results, it can be seen that there is a slight but not so distinct increase in the perception of equality of all cultures' value and treatments, with an increase in the settlement ratio. The other statement, which is constructed as fundamental rights and liberties are provided for anyone in Australia, will explore thoughts of subjects about the concept of equality. It's constructed to grasp the thoughts of subjects related to the concept of equality. Unexpectedly, there is not really the effect of the settlement ratio of subjects on their thoughts on the concept of equality in Australia. Study shows that a very high percentage of subjects state that fundamental rights and liberties are provided for anyone in Australia, which by saying agree and strongly agree, while 14% disagree and strongly disagree. The reality, which is interesting and questionable, shows the difference between the results of this hypothesis and the previous one. Although both hypotheses measure the perceptions about that either Australia treats equally all cultures from different backgrounds or not, I think that alteration of perceptions between two hypotheses related to equality is caused from the differentiation of concept selection, in which the first hypothesis includes treatment and value, besides that second hypothesis covers a more general statement has an effect of the differentiation of the results. While constructing the second hypothesis, I thought that the concept of for anyone could give an equality meaning, but it could be seen that for subjects, fundamental rights and liberties had a preliminary understanding. Subjects identify Australia as a very libertarian country, and they even consider these liberties as too much. Perceptions of multicultural policies are measured through the desire of living in a multicultural country. People may live in a multicultural country not only for their desire but also due to their necessities. I think that if their reason for living in a multicultural country is due to the necessities, they will not want to live there. Another variable affecting the level of desire is settlement duration. My hypothesis is the longer the settlement duration is, the higher the level of desire is. However, the results of my study indicate a reverse situation. Nearly 17% of the subjects with 2 and 5 year settlement in Australia absolutely agree and agree for the hypothesis that if I had an option or facility, I don't want to live in a multicultural society. While nearly 36% of subjects is an over 25-year settlement and nearly 30% of all subjects. That various necessities are more obvious with the increase of the settlement ratio and the changes are enjoyed at the first years of migration can be seen as the reason for this result. Even if there is a decrease in the rates of desire to live in a multicultural society, related with the settlement ratio, the general tendency is to live with this society. Living in a multicultural society brings together communication with different cultures and acculturation. The manners of the participant as desire to live in a multicultural country make us think that they benefit from the richness of cultural diversity and they have close relationships. Moreover, another hypothesis, which is Turkish people living in Australia generally live in a closed society, indicates a very different situation. A very high percent of subjects think that Turkish people live in a very closed society, regardless of settlement duration. This rate is higher in comparison saying that they want to live in a multicultural society. It seems that both the people who want to live in a multicultural society and the ones who don't have such a desire think that Turks live in a closed society. If it is thought that multicultural policies focus on harmony among cultures from different backgrounds and their being able to maintain their own culture freely, the sense of belongings are related with either recognition or non-recognition of themselves among host society. In this context, both the degree of their perception of how Australians consider them, immigrants feeling belonging to Australia, and their perception of Australians' consideration are remarkable. Australia's multicultural policies claim that all citizens from different backgrounds have equal rights and all of them are Australian. However, we think that the reins of white Australia policies still shape immigrants' minds. Immigrants think that real Australians are of English origin and Australians don't exactly recognize immigrants. My hypothesis is that traditional settlement has a significant impact on immigrants' perceptions of others' consideration. I can say that what immigrants think Australians consider them as reflect their own opinions. When we look at the cross-tab of the variables, which are how the Australians consider you and how long you have you lived in Australia, it indicates that subjects generally think Australians consider Turkish people as woke, which means foreigner or immigrant irrespective of subject settlement duration in Australia. There is a slight difference between an over 20-year settlement and a longer one or any other settlement duration at a different length. For instance, there is no subject who feels Australian and considers him herself before a 20-year settlement in Australia. It is important for us to grasp the recognition, the perception of Turkish people living in Australia. It will help us to measure the functionality level of multicultural policies. In this context, we constructed a statement which is the Australian will never recognize immigrants as Australian citizens. For this statement, a very high percentage of subjects from each settlement category say strongly agree and agree. Even if they are Australian citizens, they believe that they are not recognized as real citizens by Australian people. To conclude, this study provides and analyzes the impact of settlement duration on the immigrants' perception of multicultural policies. Several variables have analyzed to grasp the perception. It has been unpredictably observed that the effect of settlement duration on sense of belonging in a host country is not at the expected level. It's observed that 25-year settlement is a turning point that affects sense of belonging in a host country for immigrants. Our basic hypothesis is that if integration level of immigrants is increased, then the level of affirmation of the policies will be higher. In this respect, recognition of immigrants in the host society is very important. The identity perception of immigrants is related to how the host society considers the immigrants. Results highlight Turkish immigrants believe that Australians consider the immigrants as work, not as a part of Australian society. This result indicates that there is a slight effect of the settlement ratio on the perception of recognition. Moreover, settlement ratio has also slight effect on the affirmation of the policies. In brief, Australia is one of the most multicultural societies, still has some problems in practice. The biggest problem among Turkish immigrants can be seen as the perception of recognition. They don't believe Australians recognize them as real Australian citizens. Even if Turkish immigrants admire Australia's policies, they consider multicultural policies are implemented compulsorily, not willingly. As external perceptions affect integration level, it's observed that multicultural policies haven't fully succeeded in society level. Thank you very much.